this special edition on the outlook for equity markets and the top 10 stocks to buy in 2022 with Mr. Pankaj Pandey, Head Research, ICICI Direct. 2021 was the best year for the Indian equity markets. The Sensex moved by around 10,000 points and Nifty moved by around 5,000 points. An excellent year for equity markets. Mid-cap and small caps also outperformed. To talk on this and what to expect in 2022, now Pankaj is with us. Welcome, Pankaj.
Hi, good afternoon.
Very good afternoon, Pankaj. Excellent year for the markets as such. Well, the markets trend might, be a little volatile in the near term on account of the current situation that is arising because of the Omicron variant and fragile global cues. So what, according to you, would hold the key to the markets in 2022?
So Geetu, calendar year 2021 was very good for the markets. Nifty is up about 24%. So pretty strong set of returns what we have seen. And largely this is from the unlock lows to full recovery in a number of pockets we have seen. And I think going into CY22, we see a business landscape sort of changing, largely driven by given the innovation what we are seeing on the digital and tech world side. And that could have a multiplier effect across various layers of GDP. And it's a sort of a very crucial thing in terms of achieving a $5 trillion GDP aspiration. Now, from a market perspective, there are certain sectors which we feel will continue to sort of do well or will do exceptionally well next year. Primary among them is IT. Then you have capital goods, auto ancillaries, especially the companies which have got exposure to the electric vehicle side, retail and real estate. Now, coming to IT, so IT, overall demand cycle for IT is expected to be very strong, at least for the next 2-3 years. And global IT spend is expected to be about 8.5%. Compared to that, previously, this used to be in the range of about 2%. So you are going to see a pretty strong spend on the overall IT. And the other sector is the retail. Now, retail is only 3% of the listed companies' market cap. We see a lot of companies making their way to the markets next year. So retail is one sector which will be in limelight. Mm-hmm. On top of it, a lot of these companies have doubled the retail expansion plans. Along with that, there is a good focus on the omni-channel play, which is physical as well as digital presence. So we are expecting companies in these in this universe to deliver 30% kind of earning growth. And what we are also seeing is, historically, say, for example, 2013 to 19, the kind of capex what we had seen was driven by traditional sectors like power, mm-hmm. which contributed 1/3 of the overall capex. Now the capex landscape is also changing. You're seeing transformational shifts, especially say on the EV side, manufacturing largely, which is driven by digital automation, electronic sectors. Then there is spending expected to be on clean and green energy segments, renewables, hydrogen, and then you have urban infrastructure, especially railways and metros. Besides that, like I said, electrification is a reality and is going to pick up pace given the fact that government is very serious in terms of their electrification targets. So so that is another pocket which is expected to remain in limelight. Now, coming to Nifty targets, we have put Nifty targets at 20,000 on the back of about 25.5% kind of earning growth, what we expect over the next 2 years. Parallel levels or parallel targets for Sensex is about 66,600. Now, coming to mid-caps and small caps. Now, mid-caps and small caps had a stellar run in calendar year 21. What we see is that this run sort of continuing in next year as well, because on the earnings side, we expect about 39% kind of a CAGR growth in earnings for mid-caps, what we cover, and about 28% kind of a CAGR growth in small cap earnings. And there are certain pockets like, say, for example, specialty steel, chemical, home textiles, crams, sugar. I think these are segments where the earning potential is quite superior and valuation-wise, you don't see much of a challenge. I think the only broader issue for the markets as of now is the higher inflation, what you are seeing in the US, because in US, inflation is closer to 5%. Domestic inflation is also quite high. And on top of it, US Fed is about to hike rates, and somewhere down the line, RBI also will have to follow that normalization path. So that would create some bit of volatility. But having said that, we are still expecting next year to be a very good year for the markets overall.
Pankaj, what's your view on the financial sector as such, banking and financial sector as a whole? Because if markets have to do well, then the banking sector has also to do well. Are you expecting a move by private banks this time in 2022, which have been a laggards?
So largely in the first half, we would still not expect them to sort of outperform, because as of now, whatever CapEx announcement you are seeing is largely expected to be funded through equities. And the CapEx intensity is yet to sort of pick up. So probably if some catch up has to happen by banking and financial services, that could happen in the second half, which is why we would not say that banking overall, despite a decent risk reward setup, is expected to sort of outperform the Nifty. I think the second half, in case if the CapEx cycle is bigger and you see a lot more buoyancy in other pockets, probably there could be a case for banking to do well. But as of now, it does not look like banking overall is going to outperform. At best, its performance could be in line with the markets.
Let's now talk about the 10 top stocks that you have bought for us to buy in 2022. So which are your top picks?
So Geetu, heading into 2022, we recommend 10 stocks with a one-year perspective with upside potential of 20 to 50-odd percent. Mm-hmm. And say, for example, we are seeing a lot of tech-led technical landscape sort of changing, so which is why we have got IT and telecom companies. So the first company which we are recommending is Tech Mahindra with a target price of 2150. Now, this company has got 40% of the revenues coming from telecom. And in addition to that, the company also caters to segments like BFSI, manufacturing, retail. And historically, they have not really grown so much. So growth has been sort of a bit tepid. But over the last 12 months, we've seen good deal wins coming in. So they have won deals about $3 billion. And on top of it, company is also guiding for EBIT margin expansion. We have already seen margin expansions happening up till now, and even future also that will happen. So I think IT is another sector which will sort of is one of the core sectors which will sort of keep doing well, and which is what we recommend Tech Mahindra with a target price of 2150. Okay. The other stock what we like is eClerks. Here the target price is 2900. So it's an IT company with about 8,000 crore kind of a market cap, provides business process management, automation, analytics to financial services, communication, retail, media. And again, the last 4 or 5 years, the company's growth was sort of subdued, largely because of the abrupt contract cancellation from their three large customers between 2016 to 19. However, the company has been reporting pretty strong set of numbers of late, and has guided for about 20% kind of a growth in 22. And along with that, they have been acquiring companies. So our sense is that this company will sort of keep delivering good set of numbers. And our sense is that revenues will grow at about 16.5%. And this company is not that expensive, trading at about where we have valued is at about 21 times FY24 EPS with a target price of 2,900. Mm-hmm. Now, besides IT, you have telecom, which is also going to sort of play a big role. So you have only two major companies in telecom. One is Reliance and other one is Bharti. So we like Bharti a lot because it's a very efficient competitor, a very efficient player. So the second largest telecom operator with 36% market share and a subscriber base of about 35 crores. Here our target price is 860. And we have seen a tariff hike happening this year. There is a potential that with 5G, you will see a lot more business cases coming up, and that has the potential to further improve the overall revenue dimensions of a company like this. And with a tariff hike, we would see good amount of EBITDA growth spanning across the next 1 or 2 years. And which is where I think ROCs for the company, which was in single digits, would inch up to about 13-odd%. And the overall industry structure is also turning favorable. So you'll have two strong players and there could be a other set of measures which could come. So if 5G is not priced aggressively, I think Bharti Airtel, after a long time, has been performing a bit. Our sense is that bulk of their performance is yet to sort of happen. So, which is why we like this stock with a target price of 860. Now, I already highlighted that electrification is a reality and is picking up pace domestically, given the fact that central government is very ambitious on EV penetration. And here, to tap this opportunity, there are two ancillary companies we are looking at. One is NRB Bearings. So NRB is the largest needle and cylindrical roller bearing producer. And they export to a number of countries. 78% of the revenues come from the domestic sales and about 22% from coming from the export. Now, they are looking to invest heavily into R&D as bearing industry is seeing new opportunities from the electric vehicle segment. Now, this company has announced a capex of 200 crores focusing on R&D of new products related to EV. So, which is where we are quite excited about this company sort of doing well, and which is where we are, our target price is about 220. It's a small cap company with a market cap of about 1500 odd crores. So, which is why this same is the case with Minda Corporation. Here, our target price is 220. Similar target prices. Now, Minda is a company which serves domestic OEMs across two main verticals, which is mechatronics and aftermarket. And two-wheeler forms their larger portion, so 52% of the sales comes from there. Then passenger vehicles, about 21%. And it has a largely EV immune product profile. And interestingly, it is sort of already supplying to its products to electric vehicle OEMs, like, say, for example, Ola Electric, Ampere, Revolt. And this is one of the few companies which has sort of developed products exclusively for EV business. So DC to DC converter. So this company is will have a good role to play in terms of the transformation. And their order book has been pretty robust. We expect 25% CAGR growth in sales and ROS to improve to about 16-17% odd. So which is why we like this company with a target price of 220. Then I think on the consumption side, consumption is obviously one of the bigger themes, because given the set of population we have, consumption is something which will remain in the limelight. So Phoenix Mills is a one company which we like, where the target price is 1,200. It's a 17,000 crore kind of a market cap company. It's the largest retail mall developer and operator in India. And they operate about 7 million square feet. And they are looking to sort of develop another 5 malls with 6 million square feet. So roughly are looking to sort of double the mall space in the next 5-6 years. And which is why we expect retail rental income to grow at a 13.5% or 14% kind of a CAGR over the next few years. And in terms of funding also, they have been able to raise about 1,300 odd crores from marquee investors like GIC. So funding also is not an issue. And this company is a superior play in the overall consumption across categories in the medium to long term. And also can be considered as a recovery play from a shorter term perspective, because again, with this new COVID variant, you could have an issue in terms of not all theaters or shops operating at optimum capacity. So it's a sort of a good recovery play also, and which is why we like this stock with a target price of 1200. Radico Khaitan is another consumption play which we like. Here the target price is 1450. Now this company is among the largest manufacturers of Indian made foreign liquor. And Indian made foreign liquor contributes nearly 80% of its turnover. And prestige and above segment, which is the premium segment, contributes 30% of the overall IMFL volume. Now this, the liquor sector itself is witnessing emergence of premiumization. I mean, due to higher instances of now, people are consuming more at home compared to sort of going out, given the fact that in the last 1.5 years, the habits had to sort of had been tweaked. So with fewer avenues of customer discretionary spend, what has happened is that you're seeing a premiumization, especially in the liquor side. And this company has been capitalizing on this trend by expanding its premium portfolio, by adding several new brands in the next 2 years. And they've already demonstrated in the past, especially in the premium category, both whiskey and vodka segment they have launched. So Magic Moments, 8 p.m., so Black, Premium Black, so all these products they have launched. So it's a good play on the overall premiumization strategy. And which is why we like this company with a target price of 1450. And sugar is another sector which we like. I mean, Dwarike sugar is what we like here. The target price of is 110. And sugar industry, what we are seeing is that while the industry will be producing about 31 million tons, 27 million tons is the consumption, and with 6 million tons being exported, what will happen is the prices will get pushed up. And also we know that the government has been pushing for higher blending, ethanol blending. So this company is sort of making all the right noises. So they are looking to increase the distillery capacity from 3 crore liters to about 11 crore liters. And which is why we would expect about 40% earning CAGR for a company like this. And they're expected to generate about 530 crore kind of a cash flow. Market cap is pretty small at about 1400 odd crores. So they will be able to completely deleverage their balance sheet. And which is why we like this company with a target price of 110. Mm-hmm. And then on the infra side, we like Orient Cement because our sense is that with residential as a segment sort of doing well, I think cement is going to be a beneficiary of that. And this company has 8 million ton cement plant. It's one of the efficient players in a longish perspective. They want to sort of increase this capacity to about 14.5 million tons. And as of now, the core focus of the company is on reducing debt. I mean, so their debt was some 780 odd crores, and company has paid about 240 odd crores, and they expect the debt levels to come down to below 250 odd crores. So there is a significant amount of deleveraging which is sort of going on. And we expect that a 20% kind of a revenue earning growth and a slightly more higher bottom line growth, and with a good upside potential of nearly 50%. So we like this stock with a target price of 250. Again, market cap is not that big. It's about 3,300 crore kind of a market cap. And another stock which we like is on the healthcare side. So we have been liking the hospital as a space. I think hospital as a space has been sort of in the limelight. So this company, AstraDM, with a target price of 250 is what we like. Now, this company operates in two ways. One is they have got about 13 hospitals in the GCC, especially Dubai or the Gulf country segment. And they have another 14 hospital with a capacity of about 3,800 beds operating in India. Now, GCC contributes bulk of their revenue. 76% of the revenues come from there. Because there, if you look at the revenue per operating bed, is about 1,87,000. Compared to that in India, it's about 32,000. Now, what we like in the story is that in India, they will sort of expand more. And as the hospitals mature, typically what will happen is that the return ratios for this company will keep on improving along with better margins. And so that way, this company looks pretty good with the sum of the parts valuation. I think along with that, they also have a pharmacy and they also have a lab. So that way, I think that's another positive for a company like this. So they're utilizing the cash flows from the GCC country to fund the growth for India. And I think that that remains a good trigger for a stock like this. So this healthcare stock also we like with a target price of 250. So these are the top 10 stocks which we are recommending for investors for calendar year 2022.
Very well diversified portfolio of 10 stocks that you have suggested, Pankaj. One of the concerns that markets are really facing in the near term is the foreign investment. Foreign investors actually contributed very little to the stock markets in 2021. Their net investment has been around 26 to 27,000 crores for the complete year. So is it a concern that you see for the equity markets in India now? In fact, DIIs have been contributing a lot to the equity market.
Correct. No, I think so. The only issue is that when you look at FII numbers, people look at only last 2 months number, and definitely there has been some kind of a selling what we have seen, roughly about 60,000 odd crores. But I think if you look at 60,000 crore kind of outflow happened when the COVID had struck, right? But subsequent to that, we had seen more than 1.5 lakh crore kind of inflows what we had seen in the market, and which is why we had one of the best recoveries globally. So I think what you're seeing is a bit of a profit taking off those substantial amounts which had come. This is nothing to sort of indicate that FIIs are sort of structurally sort of negative on the markets. I think whatever inflow numbers we look at it for from a 2 year perspective, I think what selling what you're seeing is really not alarming, and I don't think that should be a worry for the markets overall. Because what we are also seeing is that a good amount of money coming on the primary market also. So if you combine both primary plus secondary market, actually the outflows are not that much. So that way, I think whether you look at standalone or combined basis, last 2 years numbers do not reflect any kind of a major worrisome factor from FI trend perspective.
If you talk about the year 2021, it was a year of IPOs. We saw many new companies coming and listing on the IPO on the exchanges with the brilliant listing, actually. And now we have LIC, the insurance big father of our insurance business, which will be coming out with an IPO in 2022. So what is the likely environment that you see for IPO market in the year to come?
I think, IPOs in general or the overall primary market looks quite buoyant even next year also. I think what is also seeing is we are seeing is financialization of savings, because earlier you had asset classes like gold or real estate where bulk of the savings were channelized. Equity markets because of the TINA factor are finding favor. And which is why you are seeing a record number of demat accounts or mutual fund portfolios being opened up. So I think calendar year 22 also looks quite robust from a pipeline perspective. And I don't think that overall you're going to see far more challenges, anything what one would have unheard of. So largely it will remain the same. So buoyancy is expected to sort of continue in calendar year 2022 also, both in the primary as well as secondary market.
Mm-hmm. Oil prices are set to post their biggest annual gains in 12 years. So do you expect this trend to continue in 2022 also?
So oil is definitely a risk factor, because while OPEC has been increasing the supply by 4 lakh barrels, I think the concern now is also coming out is that some of the OPEC member countries haven't really invested in expanding capacity or meeting their quota. So which is where it is possible that supply might take a bit more longer to sort of catch up with the demand, because if unlock happens or if this new COVID wave subsides in 1 month, 1.5 months, then I think the supply will take some time to sort of catch up. So it is possible that the crude might sort of flare up for some period of time. And that could have ramifications both in terms of inflation and also could pose challenges for RBI. So obviously it's a sort of a risk factor which is there. Structurally, I would want to believe that crude will not be a bigger concern for us, because if we are sort of very aggressive on electrification and looking at renewable energy as a primary source of energy going forward, I think that, and not only us, even globally also, so that could keep the crude or the overall conventional energy prices under check.
Mm-hmm. 28 million new DMAT accounts in 2021, as this is the data till November that we have. So what is your advice to the new entrants which are entering the markets?
So I think our experience is that it is very important to buy capital efficient companies, because capital efficient companies, even if some mistakes do happen, they have the ability to sort of recoup. And also, if capital efficient companies grow at a pretty faster clip, then the wealth creation maximum wealth creation happens then and there, because you have a capital efficient company growing at a pretty faster clip. IT is a classic example. So when I call for capital efficient company, what I mean is that you look for ROCs. So rather than sort of chasing fancy stories, I think numbers is what people need to sort of, I'm not saying look for too many numbers, but I think ROC or ROIC is a sort of a good parameter. So identify good ROC companies and see whether there is a durability of growth in the business segment what they operate in. And then accordingly, keep investing. So I think, so that is what a short answer would be, while things could be detailed in a lot more ways. But I think if you're looking for a short answer, then look for capital or high ROC companies, which are growing.
Thank you, Pankaj, for your time. Wishing you and your team a very happy and prosperous new year.
Thank you, Geetu. Wish all viewers and listeners a very happy and prosperous new year. Happy investing and be safe.
Thank you so much.
Investments in securities market are subject to market risks. Read all related documents carefully before investing.